and they're still being referred for ADHD testing. How do you explain that? Well, it's real simple. One young man, his father was locked up. He got locked up a year ago. Mother won't take him. She says she's not wasting no time to take her son up to see his daddy in jail. He should have never got locked up. So the son is being punished because the father is arrested. The son is being punished because the mother's too lazy to inconvenience herself to take him to see his father. And that brought on what appeared to be ADHD symptoms. There's all types of conditions that can mimic ADHD. So why are you so quick to reach for the pill? Everybody's so hyper-vigilant for the pill. It's because we don't want to do our jobs as parents anymore. I know we don't want to hear it, but it's the reality. Okay? Children need love, not drugs. And when a child is raised with discipline, you don't see ADHD. You don't get conduct disorder. Children who live in homes where parents have consistent discipline programs, there's no need for psychiatric medicine. This only comes up when somebody takes a break. And you have to understand, as a parent, you can never take a break. What we like to do is raise them from birth until 10 years old. And then we take a break from 11 to 14. And then at 14, when they start to get out of hand, we want to reel them back in, failing to realize that you didn't let them go. That now you can't bring them back in. And so now you reach for the pills because you took your time off. What you need to understand is, as a parent, you're going to put your time in one way or the other. You're going to put your time in from birth until age 17, or you're going to put your time in visiting your son in jail from 17 to 35. You will put the time in. Generally, by visiting a child who was not raised by a good parent when he goes to jail to get incarcerated. And so now you got to take, what, 2 and 3 trips to the prison, all types of money on his books, lawyer fees. You're going to end up spending more